Well, the story of Cinderella is very well known. In fact, some of us have learned it so well that we know it backwards and forwards. So, once upon a time in this corn country, there lived a beautiful girl by the name of Rinderseller. Rinderseller lived in a hummy krause with her mugly other and two sad blisters. Rinderseller's mugly other and two sad blisters were merry mean to Rinderseller, and they made her weep all the sashes out of the fireplace. Well, it so happened that there was a prancing hints from a Peerbine Alice who was giving a bancy fall because it was his birthday. Rinderseller's mugly other and two sad blisters went out to buy some fancy fences for the bancy fall, but Rinderseller couldn't go because all she had were some old rurdy dags. Finally, the night of the bancy fall arrived, and because Rinderseller couldn't go, she just sat down and shried. She was just kitten there shrying when who should appear before her but her gory fodgather. He touched her on the shoulder with his wagic man, and suddenly there appeared before her a kick boach and Hicks White sources to take her to the Mancy Fall. But he said, Rinderseller, be sure to be home before midnight, or I'll pern you into a tumpkin. Well, when Rinderseller arrived at the Mancy Fall, she was met at the door by the prancing hints, because he had been watching from a wooden hindo. Rinderseller and the prancing hints nanced all night till midnight. They lull and fuff. Suddenly, the mid clock struck night, and Rinderseller stays down the rares, and when she breached the rottom, she slopped her dripper. She did. Well, the next day, the prancing hints looked all over that corn country for the beautiful girl who had slopped her dripper. Finally, he came to Rinderseller's house, and he tried it on her mugly other, but it fit and did. So he tried it on her sigly usters, and it fit and did. Then he tried it on Rinderseller, and it fit and did. It was exactly the sight rise. So Rinderseller and the prancing hints got married, and they lived heavily after happer. So the story of this morning is, if you ever go to a corn country and you'd like the prancing hints to law and pub with you, don't forget to slop your dripper.
Oh my goodness.
There's another version of the story of the pea little thrigs. Well, I don't know this one. The only line I know in this one is, I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll hoe your blouse down.